G'day, this is Flat Tank Journey and I'm Chris. This is my 27 wedge tank and I've been procrastinating a bit. So you saw I got some rims and some other parts have started to arrive. And I've got a set of bars partially built and a few other bits and pieces. But I've kind of lost my way a bit, if I'm honest. So this week, I'm going to try and break the bike apart, get the hubs separated from the rims, try and measure some offsets, break everything else down, store some stuff away, and then get this frame blasted and maybe powder coated, including the front end, and then get it back together, get a mock-up engine in, and look at making some progress. I've got a bit sidetracked, so let's get on with it. To get these monster bars off, I need to remove the grips and the levers that I mocked up. So I'm going to put these away for safekeeping because I do like them. One of the viewers, forget who you are, sorry, had a suggestion of just cutting the ball off the end of the decompression lever and giving it a polish. And then when you go to get it recrumped, just get the end of the lever recrumped. What a bad idea. For some reason, the blade ones are quite expensive. Don't know. Get the right size spanner and that'll just loosen up, and then we'll get the monster bars out. I'm going to find a place to put them because I'm going to come back to those later and make some progress with them. Next job, get the tank off. Tank's got the wrong nuts on them, holding it on, but they were nice anyway. So I'm just gonna get that off and I could even start blocking that down or give it the metho test and just see whether it holds methylated spirits. But for now, tank's coming off, I hope. There we go, tank comes out nice and easy. I'm gonna take the fuel caps off. I'm gonna put them in the tub of parts, but I think I'll put the brackets back on top of the tank. With these brackets, they had special nuts, if you remember. I got them off Gary, who sold me the rear wheel. I'm gonna get the correct nuts and put them on now. Brackets go back on the tank, all nice and easy. And in here are the closed top. I suppose they're like a dome nut, if you like, but not like the traditional dome nuts that I get my jollies over. I'm going to screw the right nuts on there. And having a set of them really helps. I did work out that I think I'm missing one of the U-brackets. And I believe it goes onto the front of the tank and around the down tube. So I do need to find one of them. But I'm very lucky to have the correct nuts and they're going to look super. I'll get those on and I'll find a place to hide the tank and then we'll push on breaking it down. When I got the bike, one of the good things it had was it had a rear stand built for it to mount it, a mounting stand, but not an original stand for the bike. So it just means that the bike will stand up okay on its own. There's a rear wheel out of the bike, and really, I've done nothing with that except fit it and test fit it. I did put that sloper sprocket on it to see how it fitted, and yes, it fits and lines up. Least of my worries. I'm going to blow it apart, clean up the hub, and get it ready for powder coating. But we'll do that in a bit. Let's keep breaking the bike down. When I think about the wedge tank, I think about the term loosely assembled. And it is very loosely assembled. I don't know that the bike has actually been together and running in the last 30, 40, 50 years maybe. Who knows? I do like the way it's been stored, I suppose. But the guard there's only three bolts holding it in, and the stacks of little bits and pieces missing. But let's get it apart and see what it looks like. So there's a U bracket that is underneath it, with a piece of sticky tape or sellotape as a pad. That looks like a Chris Quinn effort. A bracket from the hardware store. And there's the original, or what I think would be the original top of the guard support piece, I suppose, is what we'd call it. I am going to put it all back together and then I'll have it. I might send it out for blasting, which is probably a good idea while I've got it apart. We'll see. Anyway, I'll put it aside and we'll push on. Decided to move sideways and take the engine out first while the frame's still got some rigidity to it and while it'll hold up on the rear stand. I think it'll be a pig to deal with once I've broken this apart. So I'm going to try and get the engine out first. Now, sadly, the top stud is hooked up on the oil pump, or the oil feed system, and it will need to take this cover off to get that to come out. That kind of shows me that the nut should be on this side of the frame, not the other side, that somebody has arbitrarily decided to put a bolt through and then put the cover on. Doesn't feel quite right, that maybe that was a poor choice they made. I think I'll just bung that in with the spare parts. Yes, I know I shouldn't put a screwdriver in there and lever things. That's really frustrating. There's a little pin in the case just here, and I'm just tapping the screwdriver down the lengthways, so it's only prying it a tiny bit. Try not to break it. And it's given up its hold. Whoa, there we go. Look at that. Haven't looked in there before. Appears to have most of it. Doesn't look too bad inside. Cam gear here. Let's see if we can get this whole thing out. Lay it on the bench. Out she comes. Let's have a look at it on the bench while we got it out. Weirdly, it actually looks kind of clean in there. No nut on the end of the magneto. Bit of a shame, but it is what it is. All the rest of it appears to be in, you know, reasonable condition. Let's call it that. Don't know what you'd actually call it, but. And there's a timing mark. There's an inlet mark. And there's. Now the gears are actually marked, inlet and exhaust. I can't see a mark on that one. Or can I? I think the mark is there. For the sake of the argument, we'll try and put them back in the right place. I don't know that there isn't a mark on that exhaust cam. I don't know where it goes. But I'm going to try and put it all back together so that at least it's not a pain in the backside. This is nothing worse. Right, there's the gear back in. Took a bit of a fight. Can't see the timing mark on the exhaust gear, and I don't quite know how it works, but, you know, there'll be it. There's the pin I was talking about. No nut here or here, and that's a bit annoying, because there should be. Anyway, it is what it is. Gonna pop that back on. Gonna put the two screws back in it, because the reality is this engine's no good the way it is. Remember the crank is as wonky as hell. Let's get back to the bike and start braking a bit more off it. Well, I'm hoping this brake lever will just unscrew, and I'm hoping it will just pull out. Is moving, but doesn't want to move too far. And this becomes the issue with these things. Once they start coming apart, they become a dog to handle. They really become annoying. Because the frames are in essence in two pieces. There's the brake pedal. Now, interestingly, it's on hex bar, and the hex bar's correct. It goes through the lugs in the frame. So that's genuine. I really like that. We'll have to disassemble it. We'll get it blasted, but it'll be good. Put that on the bench. Now, the gearbox is a bit of a dog, because it's got a stud put through it, or a bolt, to hold it in. But it's so far through and wedged that I can't get it without removing the clutch. So I'm going to try and disassemble the whole thing and see if I can get the gearbox out that way. Gearbox free. Let's pull it out of there and we can have a look at that too. The gearbox is only held in this cradle style, with two plates that are sandwiched that hold the front of the frame and the back of the frame together. Some bright spark has dropped a really long bolt in and it's hard to get apart. There's one side, looks like it's got a little repair job, or something where somebody's tried to adapt footrests, so maybe the other set of brackets are the go. And then there's a dirty great big bolt that's going to put up a fight. I've got a couple of spacers. They'll be handy, including a guard mount that may or may not be correct. That's going to cause me a problem for a little while, getting that bolt out. That's well wedged in there. Let me get. It's hard to say whether any of the fittings bolts on this are original or correct. Or if they are original, are they in the wrong place? That. Now the guard has really big openings that go right towards the center that let it go over the down tube. It actually looks in really good condition. You actually wonder whether it's been remade. Nonetheless, it's going to go off, and I'm going to get that to have a lick of sand and a prime so we can see it in the flesh, so to speak. Well, now we're making some progress. Here's the back part of the frame, and you can see it just breaks down into three pieces. Does not look like a frame in any shape or form, but there it is. That's it. I'm going to whip all the bolts out of that, whip what appears to be a special brake plate fitting out of this side, and put them away, and all of that. Weirdly, have a look at that. Didn't know that. Now, I'm assuming that's original and not a reproduction piece. It's not tubing. It's bent over. Didn't know that. All looks good though. Let's get that out. That looks like a special screw-in fitting with two threads, a bigger thread and a smaller thread for that black brake plate. Handy thing. So is that. And then that's clean. Just a bolt. Wrong size spanner. That's got a real grip on the world. Now they're interesting bolts. Interesting bolts because they've got two threaded portions. They've got a thicker threaded portion that goes through the frame and a thinner threaded portion that holds a nut. Interesting pieces. Let's get all that away into the storage tub, and then there's more pieces that can easily go for a blast and powder, or at the very least, a blast. Got the top nut off, and really, with a little bit of encouragement, this should all start to come apart. There she blows. Bearings everywhere in here because I've had all this apart before, so I'm not overly stressed because we're short bearings, there's not enough of them, they're all going to get knocked out onto the bench and I'm going to get new ones because that'll be a better way to handle it. It's at this part of the deal that you start to question whether you've actually got a motorcycle because it's broken down into a collection of parts just sitting on the floor. And it's kind of depressing. And you think, oh, really? How much did I pay for that? But it's not until you get to this point that you can really start to assess what you got. And you've got to break its back to start building it back together. Let me put this away. I think I'll take the front wheel off and then get the guard out because I don't want to damage the guard. This is about effort number, you know, I don't know, 10 or 15, taking the front wheel in and out. That should just pop out, and it does. There we go. There's the dreaded front wheel that we did all the work on, and it's pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. Now, there's that awkward nut that's hard to get to, and I seem to be able to turn it, you know, a quarter of a turn of time. I could go and get a socket, I suppose, but that'd be too easy, wouldn't it? That little bracket needs pushed out because it hooks in the edge of the guard. Didn't realise that. That's a pain in the bottom to get out, but maybe it's meant to be. one front guard and one pair of forks. Put the nut back on and you know where it is. Bracket off a blast and a bit of powder. And maybe this bit of the video is as much for me as it is for you. I'm going to just disassemble these now, or I'm going to try to. One side has nuts and it's easy to see. Well, it's easy to see the second time. I'm going to undo these nuts. Now, my understanding of these things is that we undo these nuts because they're actually locking nuts, and that this arm and this arm are actually threaded. I'm going to take this nut off and this nut off. Cool. And I should be able to turn it all over. Already I think I'm wrong. I understood they were studs that would unscrew. So the stud goes in from what I would call the right hand side of the fork, or the throttle side. And it appears to be unscrewing. And I would have thought these little arms would have been nickel plated. Yeah. And then the arms drop off the bottom. Well, they don't drop off, they come out. And they come out like that. Now I'm going to put that back together because I like things that are together. And the text runs from the back to the front. And that's a reminder for me that the text on the side arm runs back to front. Well, actually on the other side it runs the opposite way. Probably doesn't matter then. Let me screw all this back together and we'll come back to it. Again, my understanding of the bottom is that it's exactly the same. A lot of these forks have been fiddled with over time though, and have different arms on them and different pieces on them, and you've got to take them apart and they don't actually work the way you think, which is always a pain in the bottom. Anyway. These nuts are well-loved nuts. They've got a bit of burring and a bit of scuffing and stuff on them. But, you know, the shafts, the forks don't really have any play and they feel okay. Everything's coming apart nicely. I don't know that the bike has been loved, but I think it's been stored in a dry place, let's say that way. And that's still got grease on it. You know, maybe it had a grease up to sell. Who knows? Shouldn't say that. Let me put that down and I'll screw this together and then we can put the nuts back on so that we have the nuts that were with it at the very least. Whether or not they're correct, that remains to be seen. Now at this point, the forks come apart pretty easily. I think that's a genuine bolt for there, and I'm gonna take it out and put it aside because I like it. That's a good result. That can go for powder. Spring. spring comes out somehow. Spring will turn out and I'll get that spring out before it goes for powder. It turns out clockwise at the bottom and anti at the front, at the top. I'll put that aside, I'll get that out. This bottom piece, well, I probably will just disassemble it after saying I wasn't gonna, and put those parts in the tub and send this part for powder. That'll be easier. That spring took a bit of convincing to come off the bottom of that fork. It's got a sharp, flat bottom that wedges right in to the bottom of the forks. Forks are clean. They need to go now and be blasted too. When everything's powdered, they can go with the front wheel to the wheel builder to have the offset put in the correct place. Or at least I'm hoping that's what he'll do. Now, I hope I don't live to regret this, but I think I'm going to send these rims for powder as well. They shouldn't be chrome. I think it's still nickel plate era. One of them is really good and one of them is not really good. I think blast powder will even the whole thing out and they'll come out looking like they should. Kind of a shame to go over chrome, and I'm going to agonise a bit over it, but I think that's what I'm going to do. So they're going in the pile as well. Now, the last time I got wheels built, I really didn't do a great job for the wheel builder. I didn't measure the offset properly. Now, my understanding, I measured it wrong. My understanding from the wheel builder is get a straight edge, put it across the hub. Now, I've elected to put it across the surface that is the widest, which is the surface that the sprocket would go to, and measure the distance. It's about 13 or 14 millimetres. I'm going to call it 13. Now, my memory from the guy, from Gary, who I got this off, is that the offsets are equal on this. So we'll see if this side measures. And this side measures 13 as well. Yep, 13 or 14. Hey, given that the wheel's old and potentially has a buckle, that's the size of the offset. So now I can go ahead and get these spokes out and move on. I've just drifted apart the front wheel and it's come apart okay, which is pleasing. I was a bit stressed, thinking, you know, how tight were the bearings and all of that sort of thing. Now the bearings are firm in the wheel, but you want them to be. I'll put everything back on the axle, including the seal. And that goes there. And hopefully remember everything when it comes back. Now I've got to get the spokes out of that. And sadly, this is where the episode's going to end. Because I cut the cord off my angle grinder. So I've got to get a new angle grinder. Then I'm going to cut the spokes out. Then I'm going to deliver it all for powder. I hope you've enjoyed me seeing break the bike into nothing. And at this point, you can't even tell there's a Wedge Tank BSA in the shed. It's kind of disappeared. Maybe that's a good thing. I'll get all this together, get it at the powder coaters, and we'll have a look when it comes back. Thanks for joining me. Like, comment, subscribe. Cheers.